Welcome back to the channel, everyone. Michael here yet again. And today, as the title says, going to be giving my thoughts on Zack Snyder's Justice League. And to go back just a little bit of the ways, when the original theatrical release came out, I did see that in the theater. Huge fan of the Justice League character. As a matter of fact, when it comes to Marvel and DC, I was always a bigger fan of the DC heroes. As far back as I can remember, Superman has always been my favorite superhero. And there's a lot to admire in that character. So virtuous, so good, almost to the detriment of some people feeling like Superman was just a little bit too good to be true. But despite all that, Superman's always been my favorite superhero, no contest at all. And I've loved him since I was a child, and I suspect that that will probably never change. Now, other DC heroes have also been very, very high up on the list in terms of how I've enjoyed these characters. Batman, Wonder Woman, Green Lantern, Flash, even Cyborg. All these characters were much loved by myself. So I kind of share that story in that when the original theatrical release of Justice League came out, I was one of those fans that didn't hate it. And as a matter of fact, I think that for me, it was kind of a personal experience in that I was just so happy to see these characters on the big screen that alleviated a lot of the problems with the movie. And I kind of just got caught up in the experience of seeing these characters, and that was kind of like, you know, a dream come true. So I didn't hate the film. I most certainly will admit that there were problems with the movie. But all in all, I got to say, at the end of the day, I thought it was just a guilty pleasure. And when I watched the film after seeing it theatrically, for the most part, all I do is just fast forward to parts that I like. I never watch it as an entire narrative because I just, as a narrative, it's just not very good, honestly. So Zack Snyder's Justice League came out, I believe, Thursday. This is Saturday. I actually watched it on Thursday. I think being 4 hours long, I watched the entire thing, and I was up till about 2 a.m. until it was completed. And I gotta say, it was a 4 hours. I really wasn't intimidated by the 4 hour thing, because I mean, I've spent some weekends watching entire series on Netflix. As a matter of fact, I watched Pacific Rim anime on Netflix last weekend. I watched it all in one sitting, so it wasn't really a jaunting experience at all, because I'm just, you know, at this time and age, many of you, just like myself, watch entire series as they are available on Netflix. Binge watching. I've done a lot of binge watching myself, so not a big deal. Now, I've got to say, you know, Justice League, Zack Snyder's cut, there are a lot of differences between it and the theatrical version. And it is, you know, many people have said that it's almost like watching an entirely different film. And I've got to say, that's exactly what it is. It's a different film. And I'll even say it's a much better film. And as a matter of fact, I really enjoyed it. I really did enjoy this movie. And I've got to say that probably for me, the things that made this really stand out and really good for me was the character emphasis on all the Justice League. And, you know, 4 hours, that's a lot of time to actually develop your characters. And I think they did a remarkable job. Zack Snyder really did a good job with these characters. The emphasis on these characters is really, really great. And, you know, if I were to pick a particular character that really benefited from Zack Snyder's cut, is Cyborg. Because in the theatrical version, we really learned nothing about Cyborg, other than the fact that he kind of, you know, had a lot of animosity towards what had happened to him, what he had become. But in this film, you see this interaction between him and his father. You learn the backstory of what happened to his mom. And he's really a sympathetic character. You really care about this character, and you feel really badly for this character and what he's gone through. And it's like I was telling a friend last night who hadn't seen the film yet. Cyborg, you know, if you really think about that character, think of the fact that he's like, you know, mechanical arms, mechanical legs, pretty much all the flesh from the waist down is mechanical. And you've got to think that that is really, and it would really be a traumatic way of living as a human being. Traumatizing. And the film really captured that essence. It kind of explained how he felt about himself, how he felt about, you know, the loss of his mom, who he loved dearly, how he felt about his father, who was so caught up in his job that he paid little attention to him. And the point of view of his father, who loved his son, using these experiments to keep him alive, despite the fact that his son had no say-so in volunteering for becoming Cyborg. His dad just did it all on his own. Son had no say-so. And that's a pretty deep element in this character. But I think it really, really worked well. Character emphasis is really good on many of the characters. We really see the inner workings of these people. We really see the motivation behind what drives them. It's in terms of characterization, it's probably the deepest and best element of this new Justice League, even in terms of Steppenwolf himself, despite the fact that he's been redesigned, which is a plus because he looks much better in this. And he's a much more real villain this time, a really good villain, whereas in the first film, he's really superficial. In this film, you see his motivation. He wants to get back in the good graces of Darkseid, who was the ultimate bad guy in the DC universe. And, you know, a little line like, "I want to come home," that Steppenwolf says. And dare I say, just for a moment, I actually felt a little bit of sympathy for Steppenwolf. Because he's, you know, he's doing what Darkseid wants him to do. And they really brought a lot of expression to this character in that you see his eyes and you see the desire in his eyes. You see the fact that he is sad. He's tragic. But you know, it doesn't take away the fact that he's also a villain, and he needs to be stopped. But you know, the film presents him in a whole new light, with a lot of added dimension to his character, and it's really, really nice. It really, you know, your heroes can only be as good as your villain, and I think they really did a good job of personifying and giving depth to Steppenwolf as a character. So, you know, I had a good time watching this film. I really did, because ultimately I'm a DC guy. I mean, I like Marvel, but DC will always have my heart, and I love these characters. I really love these characters, and it's really nice to see them presented in a way that adds so much depth to them as characters. Ben Affleck as Batman is just really, really good in this film. I was impressed. You know, at no time while I was watching this film did I feel bored. I think the 4 hours went by really, really good. The pacing was really, really well. Now, granted, it is 4 hours, and there's going to be fans that are not so enthusiastic about these characters as I am, so you're most likely going to have a different experience. But at the end of the day, guys, I think that it was a really top-notch film. I would even, dare I say, I would even say one of my all-time favorite superhero films. I really did enjoy this one. I really did. And it, you know, being 4 hours after the movie was over, I even had the feeling that I wanted to watch it again. So, one of the things, you know, I've heard Zack Snyder say in interviews, you know, he would be asked that if the film changed at all from his original draft of the story, and he said in essence, it's the same film that I intended to make. And honestly, I find that a little bit stretching because, I mean, not too many filmmakers get to see a film that they're a part of after the fact, after it's been released, and are able to go back and make changes. It doesn't happen too much. It does happen sometimes, but not to the extent of Justice League, which is, you know, like I said, a totally different film. You don't really get to go back and make all the changes that Zack Snyder was able to do. But, you know, he benefits from the original Joss Whedon release of the film because he can look at it. He can hear what fans say about the film. He can see the critical points that films or that fans didn't like about the movie. I mean, he's got an advantage in that he can see what the fans didn't like, what didn't work. And to say that it's essentially the same film, he still gets that perspective where he could look at the movie and say, well, you know, fans didn't like this. Yeah, this doesn't work. We need to change this. So that's a benefit. He got the benefit of looking at that and seeing that it didn't work. And he was able to make changes and make adjustments. So, you know, that's really kind of, he actually benefited from Joss Whedon's release of the movie. At the end of the day, guys, I think the film works. I think it's a really adult superhero film. It has a rated R rating, despite the fact that, you know, I really didn't see a whole lot of justification for a rated R release. I mean, there are some moments in the movie that are just a little bit on the gruesome side, but I would think that just a regular PG rating would have worked. But at any rate, I enjoyed it. I really did. I really had a good time with this film. It's a really superior film in terms of the original release of the movie. I like the realism in the DC films. And I had a good time with this movie. I really did. It really kind of surprised me. I was kind of like on the fence, as I am with lots of movies. I don't really get excited about films anymore because there's been so much disappointment in films. But this is one that I enjoyed. I really did. I really enjoyed the emphasis on the characters, which is the most important thing to me. And it's just a shame that this film was not the film that was released theatrically. Now, granted, they couldn't have done it 4 hours, but they could have released a possible 3-hour version of the film, which, you know, probably would have worked just as well because there were scenes in the film that just weren't necessary. There's a few surprises. Now, if I was to criticize anything about the film, I would say that the multiple endings was really kind of unnecessary to me. There's a dream sequence at the end with Batman, which I felt was just, you know, unnecessary, totally unnecessary, featuring the Joker. And it felt really just indulgent, wasn't needed. I think that the movie just could have ended after the good guys win and a little bit of a wrap up. So I don't think that was really needed, as it felt like a scene that was trying to plant the seeds for a possible sequel. And who knows in the film industry, who knows, maybe there will be a sequel to Justice League. I mean, whoever would have thought that Zack Snyder would have got to go back and present his version of the film. But at any rate, there you have it, guys. My thoughts on Zack Snyder's Justice League, a really enjoyable film for me. Thanks for watching, everybody. Take care of yourselves, and I'll see you in the next video.